Good afternoon and welcome to Spielberg, and to a circuit that in one form or another has held every Austrian Grand Prix in the championship, except the very first back in 1964. It was at this race that John Watson lost a bet and his beard when he took Team Penske's only F1 victory in 1976. If anything, the stakes are even higher today, with 25 points available for victory and a crucial advantage in the championship fight. It's a short lap here in Spielberg with just 10 corners, 7 rights and 3 lefts, making up the total distance of 2.6 miles. And expect to see a lot of cars running wide today, especially through the last corner, as the wet conditions make the cars skittish through the downhill sections. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk briefly about Carlos Sainz. As ever, the threat of unreliability is never far away, and indeed they'll be starting out of position today due to a power unit component change. So it's going to be a difficult task to move forward from there.
Everyone has to deal with penalties or reliability issues from time to time throughout their career. You just have to suck up the pain and get on with the job at hand. Today isn't about performing a miracle to put the car back where it should be. It's about effective damage limitation.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Daniel Ricciardo starts from pole position today, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Vettel, Kevin Magnussen, and Perez, Grosjean, Ericsson, Bottas, and Pierre Gasly, Hamilton, Hülkenberg, Lance Stroll, and Sainz, Ocon, Hartley, Fernando Alonso, and a Ferrari. Van Dorn and Sergei Sorokin rounds off the grid.
Keep your eyes open on the run to turn one and keep it clean. We want to come out in one piece. Good luck.
Thank you.
increase ERS deployment to overtake mode. We're seeing light rain about 2 minutes away. Some information on Ricardo. They have some kind of mechanical problem. Situation is an interesting one, but I think the right call is to stick with what we've got right now. 2.4 seconds. Verstappen has the lead. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Got that confirmed? Our last stop, no more scheduled pit stops. Sebastian is in the pits. Verstappen's out in front. still happy that we're on the right tyres at the moment? Seconds. Virtual safety car, virtual safety car. Reduce speed immediately and keep a positive delta. Okay, slow down, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. Ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Okay, clear. Seconds. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. Really dry enough yet to start thinking about slicks. Let's hold on to the inters for a while longer. This lap of the race so far. seconds. There's three laps of fuel remaining. That looked bad. Are you all right? Let me know you're all right. This is great work so far. Six places up on our target, six places above our target. This is your final lap of the race. Has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. That's a podium. Excellent drive. The team have worked especially hard this weekend, and this is a fantastic reward.
A great win then for the Red Bull team today. So, Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Well, keeping their tyre temperatures up in the tricky wet conditions was really important. There's not much grip out there at the best of times, and it's 10 times worse if you're out there on cold tyres. So the way they kept the rubber in its proper operating window was a huge advantage today.
And I can see now the drivers are making their way out. We need Red Bull fighting at the front. They do an incredible amount for Formula One. And that's another winner's trophy heading back to Milton Keynes. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Our current points leader extends their lead at the top of the championship after a very good result here today. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
It's a difficult call, but I'm going to have to give it to the Ferrari driver. They pushed and pushed and found some fantastic performance. It was just a pleasure to watch.
On to the constructors then. Ferrari extend their lead at the top of the championship. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.
out there. You must be really happy. You were cutting your way through the field during the race. You must be happy with the result today. Would you say that your rival is still on your level? You're beating all expectations. Would you say we all underestimated you? Appreciate your time.
Just wanted to say congrats on the podium. It's thoroughly deserved. We were sweating those last few laps on the pit wall, but you brought it home.
Okay, we had the new parts come through from the factory. We'll get them on the car ahead of FP1.
Remember to select a driver that you consider your rival from the rivalry screen on the workstation. Performing well against your rival can earn you respect and better terms when it comes to our contract reviews.